on past visits to Coolima.
Holy shit, look out.
The first cattle muster sorted out the men from the boys.
Holding on tight.
Okay.
The rookie caught the eye of the girl next door.
I'm surprised he didn't end up with a sunburnt crack because his backside was always showing.
Here.
And the Joneses surprised the cook with a thoroughbred for his comeback as a jockey. In this episode, the teenagers come home and everyone gets into the fun.
It's like something you'd see in a James Bond movie or something, look.
Jeff tries to look and act like a coolie bar cowboy.
Oh, I just caught it myself now.
And Milton leads the search party.
You copy there, Milton?
When a mate goes missing.
You'd lost and perish in this country quick.
At Coolibar, the dust has settled on yesterday's muster. After doing some hard yards getting the first mob of cattle to market, everyone's got the day off. Some are returning to old routines. Others are heading off station.
Are you excited about having time off?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, definitely. And get to go to the big city.
The big city.
The big city.
And a few can't stop thinking about work.
A turtle.
What's its name?
Shelly.
Shelly.
Little Milton's introducing his Aunt Christy to the newest addition to his pet collection.
Yeah, but he doesn't bite. He doesn't bite.
All right, we'll put him back in his little pen.
But not all the critters at Coolie Bar are as harmless as Shelly. The top end is crawling with creatures that can kill.
Kill snake! You got him, Christy.
Brown snakes are the most poisonous in the country, even the little ones.
Is he dead?
When one gets this close to the homestead, there's only one thing to do to avoid a tragedy.
If the venom got in little Milton, it'd probably kill him. You gotta be really careful.
Yeah, it's poisonous one. It has too much poison.
It does.
So it'll kill you.
Ooh.
Clothing, first up.
This would be my favourite shop in the whole town.
North of the station, Rainey's helping Jeff sort out his own serious problem.
Yeah, sure.
Flashing everyone at work.
The ladies will know what size you are.
34.
That's because you wear your pants down around your ass.
I chucked in an extra hole in my belt just so they'd pull up a bit more, but doesn't seem to be working too well.
You done yet?
I'm chucking on some jeans.
Jeff decided to bite the bullet. The low-slung jeans and the city gear are gone.
Show me how high they are. Lift your shirt up. Yeah. As long as your butt crack's not going to hang out.
From the looks of things, he's going to need all the help he can get.
You know that there's a rule, never trust a bloke in a black hat? That's better. That's like 100% better than when you walked in here.
You reckon?
Yes, definitely. What's with the bird noises and arm action?
It's a bit of a change up from boarding in a singlet, huh? Wear now.
Back at the ranch.
You're too hot out here for me.
Nobody's looking forward to a day off as much as Milton.
Hang on a sec.
What do you heard? What's happened?
But one phone call is about to change everything.
Keep us informed, eh? Righto.
What happened?
She's finished then.
What happened?
Milton's had word that one of his men on the ground crew didn't get back home from yesterday's muster.
Dave didn't get back until late last night. He reckoned Dooley hadn't turned up.
Yeah, we got a call that he wasn't there. They keep an eye on him at the rodeo. So if he's not home every night, they let me know.
75-year-old Jim Dooley is Milton's oldest cowboy, and he was last seen in his ute doing maintenance work.
Hey, copy there, Dooley.
He's starting to get a bit frightening, actually. His old memory's going, eh? You always think the worst, eh, when you can't get him on the radio. I'll get up high, old Dooley. He's got a two-way in his motor car. So I'll get up about 3,000 feet and give him a call, and I should be able to pick him up, find out where he's at.
Yeah, right. Yeah.
Got it. See ya.
Someone goes missing at Coolibar, it's everyone's business.
Just having a look at the dam and he's not there, so we'd better go for a look a bit further down.
Very much.
Pilots Stephen and Mick are joining the search.
You'll be able to come out this way, Mick.
Down that creek, down that creek, eh?
Someone goes missing, you've got to be straight out there looking for him, you know. Pretty hard sort of country at the end of the year. You'd lost and perish in this country quick.
Just things go pear-shaped quick when you get lost out here.
Hey, copy there, Billy.
Milton and his two best pilots are combing the rugged country for any signs of the 75-year-old.
Jim Dooley, do you receive?
The day's heating up, and still no sign of Dooley or his ute.
Oh, just check this out, eh?
But finally, a breakthrough.
Stop me left door now, eh?
Well, that looks like Dooley's ute. We'll see if there's any signs of life down there. Yeah, you on channel there, Jim? Hello, Jim. You hear us there, mate?
He's not talking on the radio. He might have a flat battery or something. Hopefully that's all it is. He's not moving, so I have to land here and make sure he's all right. Hopefully nothing serious has happened here. Might be just broken down, hopefully.
Hello. Oh, the old fella's waving. Must be all right.
Cheeky bastard.
Christ, old fella, you give us a fright, eh? All been out looking for you.
Yeah, g'day, it's Mick. Hey, I found Jim. Reckon he's got a broken drive axle and he's rear diff. Yeah, he's all right, everything's good. He just said he didn't want to lift anywhere because he was worried that he'd knock off all the gear out of his Toyota. Righto, see ya.
We'll work something up.
All right, thanks, Dave. Hello. Do you get your biggest hole in your pants?
They're all his own.
Yeah, I'll get it sorted.
I'm so stoked with my new hat.
Hey?
Yeah.
Are you going to wear it?
Hell yeah.
Good.
200 k's north of the station, Rainey and Jeff are unaware of the drama back home.
What do you reckon? Just need to rub some mud on it?
The downside of going to town is you get stuck running everyone else's errands.
What is this?
From grabbing spare parts for Hamish or horse feed for Christina.
I'm just watching as she does everything.
He's such a gentleman.
Yeah.
Ah, oh, and there's also a little package to pick up.
That is a big-looking croc.
Oh, I thought it was looking small.
It's a rogue salty, captured alive, and it needs to be relocated.
Have you touched it yet?
Touched its tail, yeah.
Its tail? What about its teeth?
Nuts. Are you kidding?
This is the first time Jeff's ever seen a crocodile.
So how come it's not moving? Like, I thought it'd be thrashing.
He's a bit tired, mate, and we've given him a shot of Valium.
We don't really want him bouncing around in the back of the car.
Yeah, well, that was my thoughts. I'm all good.
Cured for life.
Rainey's taking the sleeping giant back to her croc farm.
Come.
When he wakes up, the old salty will see out his days in a breeding program. Lucky fella.
Thanks very much.
I can't believe we've got a croc sitting in the back of the ute. Look at that.
On the way back through town...
OK, what do we want?
Jeff decides he's not going to let a man-eater stop him from getting a treat.
I'm not saying Chef's food's bad, I'm just saying we're a true star.
Wow. I think they're getting a good view back there.
Yeah, this bad boy.
Oh, I just caught it myself. Nah. We just went and picked it up.
Oh, right.
Just went and picked it up from around the road.
Oh, no. Stop.
As you do.
Thanks. You too. We got a doggy bag for our friend in the back. No, I was just joking.
She ran real. See you, man.
Yeah.
30 k's south of the homestead, Coolibar's mechanic Dave is on his way to fetch Dooley.
I reckon he might be embarrassed. He lives on iced coffee, so I got him on there. That'll keep him going for a while.
Dooley spent a night and morning sticking by his broken down ute. So Dave is a sight for sore eyes.
Geez, you're a wild looking man, aren't you? Hey, got your breakfast and all. Spoiled or what?
I'm too tired to get out of here, right?
And what have you done to her, old fella?
Doesn't take Dave long to work out what's wrong.
The wheel bearing, I think.
We can't really tow it home. It's going to have to go on a truck.
That's all we can do with him, mate. We're up in there, we can hide it early. We'll pull all that gear out.
Yeah, you just keep an eye out for each other.
You've got to, if you're going to survive, you've got to keep an eye out for each other.
For Dooley, it's been a long day.
I'll take you home to bed, eh? And don't expect me to tuck you in either.
I slept last night. In a tangled sort of a way.
He's like an old home in Pigeon. It might take him a while, but he'll always find his way home.
You're all safe. That's the main thing, Dooley.
He's pretty tough, old Dooley. He'll be right.
He's right. He always carries a blanket and a pillow in his motor car.
But not everyone's getting a welcome home on their return.
Oh, look at this. You want to take it back, have you? Look, shit.
No, cheers, mate.
What have we got here? It looks like a real cowboy now.
Turn around and give us a look at you. There you go, good pair. Oh, good jeans too, eh?
All decked out.
That's the go, mate.
Milton seems to like it, I guess. Trev doesn't like it, which is even better because I like it that much more now. So, it's good.
Up. A long back.
A little bit of horse-like quack when you get up.
Yeah.
Little Milton's a happy boy. His big brother and sister are coming home.
Hey, let me go now.
Yeah. Good to have a little brother. I always wanted a brother. Hopefully I'll be able to teach him a few things.
Milton's just picked up Bo and Alex after 10 weeks at boarding school.
Oh, yeah, they grow up real quick, don't they, eh? I don't know anyone that doesn't miss their kids. But that's life up here, eh? That's what you got to live with.
It's good to see my dad. I don't see him that much. I only see him on the holidays.
The kids come home from school and everyone has a bit of fun, eh?
We'll have a few days off and go fishing. The fishing's pretty good, and maybe go jet skiing or something in the river, put the boat in.
No, Captain, grab the boat, Captain.
Don't fall off, or I shall crack your head open.
I line the hose.
But it's not all fun and games.
Do a bit of work for Dad. Maybe get a little bit of pocket money.
Going?
Having a bit of trouble at the moment.
This job's going to test everyone's patience.
You better not be up walking backwards and forwards. Oh, shit.
Especially Milton's.
When Dad's getting heated, I can tell because he takes his hat off.
Oh dear, no hat.
So I don't have to walk all the way backwards and forwards, do you?
I'll tell you.
You got to tell me
yep.
whether to keep going or to get out of the truck or come back.
All right.
That's what you're here for?
Yep.
Righto. Not for me to get in and out of the truck all the time.
No.
So when it's straight,
yep.
tell me to come back.
He's a good dad.
Bit of a hard bastard sometimes, but he's good.
That's why you employ truck drivers. We're helicopter pilots, not truck drivers.
See, if you weren't here, I would have got howled at.
This is day one of the regime of getting on the horse. So we'll see what happens.
Trevor the Cook's in training for his return to racing.
Piss off.
The horse is a champion thoroughbred.
That.
Trouble is, he hasn't been ridden for about a year.
This is when we try to get on his back and see how good he is.
Let's be honest, the real trouble is that Trev hasn't raced in 25 years.
I was just trying to lie on his back.
It's more guts than glory at this stage, but if Trevor thinks he's got the inside running, he's in for a shock.
There you go, they got the head down now.
This is Milton's sister, Terry.
That's a rail rider.
She can ride as well as any Coolibar cowboy.
Look out!
And she's come to the station to take on one bloke.
Trevor and I are competing against each other in a race, and he's lost so much weight. So I'm going to sabotage him when I go over. I'm going to put everything in his coffee or whatever I can. I'll make him a fat little bastard.
Well, I guess there's nothing like a little rivalry.
Skinny lunch today, Trev?
No, it's a fat one for you. Skinny one for me, but a fat one for you. You'd have to buy me a beer after the race.
You'll have to buy me one.
I'm just going to kick your ass.
Sledging aside, Terry's come to Coolibar to do an important job.
Feels nice, doesn't it? Nice to have a haircut.
When the nearest salon is 200 k's away, you bring the hairdresser to you.
You're doing well there, young fella.
Now it's Milton's turn to get his ears lowered. And when Big Sis is doing the cutting, you'd better sit still and listen.
Milton had come over from Kingaroy to see me, and he thought this, can I say, this girl looked all right. And I said, well, you can spend a bit of time with her only if you let me perm your hair and colour it. He said, yeah, do whatever you like if it means I can sit here and watch her.
That lady turned out to be Christina. Not really, but it would have been a good story.
OK, little Milton, do you want to do the dusting of Dad's neck?
Quick, dust me. You might be a hairdresser, right?
Yeah, that's what we're planning.
OK, all done.
Hey, okay. How good's that?
Beautiful.
Thank you very much.
Pleasure.
That's a good haircut.
Beautiful, look at that.
You're going to run over and get a beer off Mum?
At Coolibar, it's been a long, eventful couple of days off.
We don't often get down here at all, really.
But the Joneses can finally enjoy a family holiday at home.
Jet ski skiing and having a few beers and a few nibblies, eh? Bit of fun.
Dad's a pretty good jet skier because he's not game enough to fall in.
You'd think they'd be worried about all the crocodiles.
You gotta get on from the back, Dad.
Aye?
You gotta get on from the back.
But they're not.
Far out, that'd give me a fright.
You try not to think about it too much when you're sitting in the water waiting for the jet ski to come back around. First run I had this morning, I saw a little one down further, but yeah, it wouldn't be enough to eat me, I don't think.
Not saying that they're not gonna be here, but we just built one.
Perhaps they should be listening to the voice of reason.
There's a big crocodile down here. It's just loose there. When you're there, driving with walking, you have to be really careful.
Forget the crocodiles. Right now, the biggest danger in this river is Milton in a chopper.
It's like something you'd see in a James Bond movie or something, look.
I don't know if I trust Milton that much.
Pretty soon, they'll get back to some heavy-duty mustering. So days like this are priceless.
It's a really nice family weekend.
Oh, it's great. Really good, really important to have family around.
Bit of fun in the bush, Wags?
Yeah. Having an opportunity to chill out and have a good time with everyone doesn't happen that often, so when it does, it's kind of special. Yeah, it's nice.
Whoa!